reason Dr. Greger is still my go-to for information, even after all these years, is because to the best of my knowledge, he's never afraid to admit when he's wrong. When any new research is released that contradicts what he's told us previously, he always tells us. In a recent interview, he shared the piece of advice he had to retract that perhaps weighs most heavily on him. So let's take a listen to that clip and then come back and look at another study that has concerned me on something I was consuming daily.
I'm always, tweaking and adding new things. I mean, just as I learn more, I'm trying to think, oh, there's some things that have certainly been removed. Oh, my God. Erythritol, for example, appeared to be this kind of harmless, low-calorie sweetener. And it turns out it's only harmless because we hadn't tested it sufficiently. And once we did, we found out it may be causing cardiovascular disease. So that's something I obviously stopped and tried to shout from the rooftops to get people to stop doing it and felt this tremendous burden that I had led people astray. It goes in both directions. And that's why it's just critically important that, I make sure that everything I put out there is, fact-checked. We have our own fact-checker on board. Now I have 20 staff, so we have this whole kind of research army. Make sure that, anytime some new study comes out, we can really put it in context of everything else that's been published on the subject in the past, so we don't get led astray by some kind of tangential new data point.
After seeing xylitol, another sweetener, was looking promising for dental health, I started using it every day. However, when this research came out, indicating that it also may be associated with increased cardiovascular risk, I temporarily stopped using xylitol. Now, it's true that further studies are needed, and some health educators I respect have debunked this research, but I'm still very cautious. Next, we'll look at, according to Dr. Greger, which the only two healthy sweeteners are.